I see way more than 100 out here right now. What do you say? What does 100 sound like?
Ultimately, the reason we're out here is because this hospital and the HCA Corporation, they continuously put nurses out of ratio and in unsafe situations. And on top of that, we're going for hours without breaks, without water.
It's a 10-day strike. We are on day 7. We're pleading that our CEO understand from what position we're coming from. This is not contract negotiations. We are asking for safer working environments so our patients get better care. What happened with one of my patients is I'm the only chemo nurse on the floor. And so they bundled for me to have 3 patients at the same time. They all had their chemo started at the same time, and I had one patient that was asking for a pain medication. And while I'm stuck in a room starting chemo in my full-up gown, I did not know that my patient was asking for pain meds. And when I finally was told by other nurses who are also drowning on the floor because they're full with their other patient load, my patient left because he felt like no one cared about him. And that's not the message we should be sending to our patients, especially during COVID. We should have the staff to care for every patient that walks through those doors.
You know, the coronavirus is rising up again. They're closing the restaurants again. You know, we're gonna get hard once again. We need the proper PPEs. We need the proper staffing. If not, if the nurses get sick, who's gonna take care of us? Who's gonna take care of the patients? Who's gonna take care of your family members?
So it's really difficult to go without pay. I'm a sole supporter. I have 4 children at home, and we're going 10 days without pay.
We're not asking for much. Safe staffing. And when you can get hundreds and hundreds of nurses to go without pay for patient care, that's enormous.
So I understand they're stressed. They're a good group of nurses out there, you know, that have done a lot of great work. And so certainly we're going to respond and make sure that their needs are addressed. We are responding to their request for staff. We added 300 nurses in this past year. On top of what we had at the time that we started the mediation agreement. So I feel really confident that our staffing ratios are maintained.
The solution is to follow the law. Give us the appropriate amount of staff that we need to safely take care of our patients. I told you that I'm a code blue nurse, and I see the worst of the worst because these nurses are put in unsafe situations.
When you're hearing their demands, what you're hearing is talking about break relief. But at the bedside, we're maintaining those ratios, and that's my priority focus, is I've got patients in a bed that need to be cared for, and I absolutely want to provide lunch and break relief, but not at the expense of the patient.
In California, there are laws to be followed. Title 22 means that you have to keep a ratio of nurses, meaning this ratio means in my department, labor and delivery, the maximum number of patients I can get is 2.
Oh, I'm not getting up on you.
They want me to take 3. Unsafe for that mother.
I do not care about my pay. What I care about and all these other nurses care about is the patients and their lives. That's why these nurses are here. They bring their hearts every day to work.